If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in GATE measurement series. So today we'll be solving again 5 questions, starting from question number 56 to up to question number 60. Okay, then let's try to solve these 5 questions. An unbalanced DC Wheatstone bridge is shown in the figure. At what value of P the magnitude of V0 will be maximum? Okay, so you can calculate the magnitude of V0 in terms of P, then you differentiate it to get the maximum value, how when it will be maximum. So for that maximum, you know, what is your V0? V0 will be this voltage minus this voltage. Again, you can consider AB. So your V0 will be VA minus VB, like the solved in other one. So what is VA? It is E is divided into two segments, this into this. So you can take this voltage, that is E PR divided by voltage division, PR plus R into 1 plus X minus, okay. The next again PR divided by, this voltage is also PR plus R. So this is your V naught. So for, you want to V naught maximum, maximize V naught by changing P. So you will differentiate V naught by changing P. So you will differentiate with respect to P, and then make it to zero. So E will be constant, you can take outside. So EPR, if I take constant, let me just simplify there first, then I will differentiate it. You can take R common in both, from all, you can take denominator, you can take R common. So RR would get cancelled. So it will be 1 by P plus 1 plus X minus 1 by P plus 1. So if you take EP, then it will be P plus 1, P plus 1 plus X, P plus 1 minus P minus 1 minus X. So PP 1 1 will get cancelled. So once you know this one, this is your V naught. So you differentiate it V naught with respect to VP. So denominator square, P plus 1, P plus 1 plus X whole square. So that is not required because ultimately you will be making it to 0 for maxima. So it will be gone there. It will be already gone. So minus X is also constant. So you keep it also outside. So rest you keep. P is the variable. So first denominator constant. P plus 1, P plus 1 plus X, then differentiation of numerator. Numerator only P is left, so differentiation is 1. Minus numerator, and then differentiation of denominator. What is the differentiation of denominator? This will be, you will get, if you make P plus 1 constant, then differentiation of this one is 1. Plus, if you take P plus 1 plus X constant, differentiation of P plus 1. U into V I have applied. So ultimately everything will be gone. You will left with P plus 1, P plus 1 plus X. And this side will be P into, so if you open this bracket, finally you will get it, okay, let me write it, P square plus P plus XP plus P plus 1 plus PX minus 2 P square minus 2 P minus PX equal to 0. So PX, PX gone, PP, 2 P gone. So ultimately you will get XP minus P square, this one is X, sorry. So you will get PX, PX get cancelled, so you are left with this X, only X. So you will get P square equal to 1 plus X or P equal to your, obviously you cannot take minus, so positive 1 will be the answer. That is root 1 plus X. That is option A. The items listed in 1 has to be made in reasonable accuracy. Various types of measurement using suitable bridge. Types of items are listed. List 1 and list 2. You have to do matching between list 1 and list 2. Your bridges. Okay. If you know bridges, if you study little bit of bridges, you know which bridge in basic idea you should have. Wheatstone bridge you know for normal resistance by comparison type or whatever you can think of by comparing it measures. Kelvin double bridge are for very low resistance so that our resistances of the wire can be nullified. Shearing bridge is for capacitance, you must have known. Wind bridge is for frequency, very important every time MCQs comes for any exams. Hayes bridge also for inductance. Carry Foster bridge for resistances. This Carry Foster, Kelvin bridge, double bridge, Wheatstone, these are the basic bridges. So if you start with, so you can write it now. So in the exam, you if you don't know all bridges, you see how many you know. So that's what you, the resistance in milliohm row, so that you know, that for that you need to use Kelvin double bridge. So you can say A with two options, lots of are there. So for low value of capacitance, you have seen shearing bridge is for capacitance, so obviously it will be shearing bridge. So B will be equal to 3. So that's it gone, 2, 3, 2, 3. AC is either A or C. Then you come to C. C is what? See, is a comparison of resistance which are nearly equal. So for resistance there is another bridge, that is carry foster bridge, so it is 6 already. So you can see, and it is option for D, it will be 5. That is, Hayes bridge is for inductances of large time constant, or Hayes bridge for inductance. So this is option A. Now if you come to 58, the bridge circuit shown in the figure below, which is one of the sequence given below, is most suitable for balancing the bridges. So for balancing the bridges, you need to find, because we take this one is unknown, R1, J1, this is unknown branch we generally take. So we will try to find R1 and X1 means L1, we will try to find the expression of R1 and X1. We will see how these variables are playing with there. So what is your this branch into this branch equal to this into this, that is the bridge balance condition. So if you start with this R1 plus J, R1 plus JX1 multiplied by R4 minus JX4 should be equal to R2, R3. So you can separate this real element scenario. What will be your real part here? R1, R4, this and this will give you real, and this will give you real. So this minus J square will make the plus. So plus X1, X4 is equal to R2, R3. So this is one part if you separate real. And imaginary part, there is no imaginary part. So imaginary part, this side will be 0. And this side imaginary part is X1, R4, this into this, and then this into this, minus R1, X4. So if we apply this one now, here it is R1, R4. And what is X1? J, omega L1, J is not required. What is X4? Omega 1 by omega C. So omega will cancel, so it will be L1 by C4 is equal to R2, R3. Here X1 is R4 by L1, R4, and it is R1 by C4, because this is capacitance, so 1 by omega C4. This is inductance, omega L1. So this is 0. So from here you can see your R1 is equal to, this is omega, this is also omega, so it will be omega square this one. So you found the expression for R1, which is depending on L1. You put R1 value there and you calculate L1. So if you put L1, R1 there, so what will be your L1 by C4 plus R4 into, instead of R1 I am putting this one, omega square L1, R4, C4, and then R2, R3. So you can play around with this and take L1 common, and finally if you do this expression, your expression will be R2, R3, I am directly adding it, C4 divided by 1 plus omega square, R4 square, C4. Now you can see, because this variable is depending upon, you can see numerator it is R4, C4, L1. You see your L1, you see options. There are, first you change R2, R4. There are the options. These are the options. So you play this one. Whether you will change R4 or R2. So you see, if you change this expression, L expression, here it is directly depending on R2. So if you change R2, L1 will be changing very drastically. It will also change if you change R4, but that will not be so drastically, because there are lots of other factors are there also. So that will also take care of, that will be multiplied, then 1 will be added. Frequency will also be a factor. So this is not a dominant player over there in the denominator, but in the numerator it is a dominant player. If you multiply it 2 times, though, it will be simply multiplied by 2 times. So your L1 can be changed by using R2. So once your L1 is kept fixed, then you can change you cannot say C4, because C4 will be also being hugely impacting L1. So direct impact is there. So you can change only R4. So first if you change R2, then you can change R4. So if you see expression, if you put L1 is also there, one more time I am explaining. Omega square L1, instead of L1 if you put R2, R3, C4, then R4, C4 square divided by 1 plus omega square R4 square. So this if you put, it L1 is also there. Now if you see which one is not common here, R4 is not common. So you keep this R4. R4 is there in the denominator, but it is not so much impacting L1 and R1, because this impact is less here. And if your Q factor is high, this will be also neglected. I am not going for Q factor because they have not mentioned. So you can neglect it with respect to 1, then it will be neglected. So okay. So if you remove, if you think that R4 is not so much impacting, if you see only numerator, which one is independent here? R4 is not connected here. So keep that R4 for last. First you change R2, because that is impacting both. So if you change R2, fix L1, then come to R4, tune R1. That is the idea. So that's why it is option C. The AC bridges shown in the figure is used to measure the impedance Z. The bridge is balanced, then the impedance Z will be. So you can again, so 500 into Z should be equal to 300 plus suppose this L I am doing, so j omega into frequency they have given, so f is given, so you do this modification kindly. So f is 2 kilohertz, so you put it is 2 × 10³, then multiplied by 15 × 15.91 × 10⁻³, this milli, this one multiplied by again 300 minus j by omega is 2 pi, f is 2 × 10³, and then this one is 0.398 × 10⁻⁶. So this calculation I am not doing, you can do it this calculation. If you do it, this side will be 300 plus j 200, and this side will be 300 minus 200 j, which is easy for you to calculate. So it will be a square minus b square, so it is a square, minus here will be plus because j j will give you minus a square, which will make you plus. So from here you can calculate your z, 500 into z, so your z will be equal to 260 ohm, that is your option A, 260 plus j. Again, this cross product, this into this should be equal to this into this. So R2 into R3 should be equal to R plus j omega L, that multiplied by this one. So this one is parallel combination R4 into minus j by omega C4 divided by R4 minus j by omega C4. So this you can take that side and then you can take product. So it will be R2 R3 multiplied by R4 minus j by omega C4 is equal to R plus j omega L multiplied by minus j by omega C4. So if you take only real part both side, so what is real part here? R2 R3 R4, then if you multiply it will be imaginary, and this side real will be equal to, if you multiply these two, jj again give you minus, so this minus will be plus, so it will be omega L divided by omega C4. So if you calculate L here, omega omega will be cancelled, so it will be R2, R3, R4, C4. Oh, I think I missed there R4, so one R4 was there, R4 into this. So if you do this one, R4, R4 will get cancelled, there is one R4, so R4, R4 will get cancelled. So you will get R2, R3, C4, so L is equal to R2, R3, C4, that is your option A. You can see only one is L there, no need to calculate imaginary part. So you can calculate imaginary part to find R. So if you do imaginary part, then I am writing, you will get it like this R, if you equate the imaginary part from both sides. If you equate real part, then you are directly getting L. So L is only one option is there with this, no need to go for another one. You can end the exam, you can directly take option A. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.